Are you guys ready to tell me what to write? Then I'll try to make a progress here. Oh.
So
and start with the simple tables.
We need to create three tables.
Mm-hmm. So this one.
Articles.
Articles.
No parentheses.
Mm-hmm.
Inside the parentheses, I think we need an.
Oh, sorry.
We need an ID, title, and content.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So,
so
ID would be an integer.
Mm-hmm.
What is the 10? What is the 10 to note?
It's I'm not sure if you actually need to write it because I think it's the default. But it has something to do with how big a number you can display or something. It's not the it doesn't actually affect how large the number can be.
Okay.
It's more it's not like with strings where you say 255 is the maximum.
Okay.
So I'm not really sure exactly how to describe it, but it's in the manual if you want the technical.
So
int 10 and then
that's going to be our primary key.
Is it unsigned?
Yes.
All right.
Can't be negative. Auto
mm-hmm.
increment because it's an ID.
Yeah. And I guess we also need the increment. We also need not null, right?
Yes.
Not null.
And what about primary key? Do we need that as well?
Yeah, but we'll define that in a statement below.
Okay.
So we got ID, and then we need, what was it? Title and content.
What's the order of the data types relevant?
You mean like if I define title first and then ID?
No, the data types thing, if you put assign behind auto increment or auto increment behind not null.
Yeah, I guess these two could be switched around, I think, but these two kind of belongs together.
Okay.
So unsigned is kind of like a follow-up to the int statement.
Okay.
But I'm not 100% on that.
Okay.
But this is usually the ordering they come in.
Okay.
So title, what would you say that is? Is it varchar text? Varchar?
Varchar is our 255.
Yeah, let's just make it as big as possible. And then I guess not null also. Yeah. And for the content?
Text.
And not null.
What's the difference between text and write?
Text is like a book kind of length. You can put. Mm. Yeah, there's like they actually also like small text and big text. I think if you want to have the whole Shakespeare collection in one row, you could probably something like that. And then we need to define a primary key for this table. So primary key, and that should, of course, be the ID. Well, that's the first table. So create table, and then it's authors, I guess. Oh. Authors. So I'm just gonna write the same here, cause I hope you use the same data type for all your primary keys. Otherwise, you get into trouble. So what about name? Watcha? I would probably say that as well. That's the usual. Not null. and primary key is also ID. Then we have tags. ID int unsigned. No, no. Increment. And what did we say? Tag name. And I'm guessing most of you used varchar again here.
Yeah. I'll say more.
I would certainly do that. No. Okay. Then the interesting stuff. The two join tables. Was it article authors? And article tags. So what did you put into article authors?
Author ID.
Okay, and we need to define some foreign keys here. Hmm? Yeah. Oh, and yeah, also we need the primary key, of course. So, the primary key, what is that going to be? So it's author ID. And article ID, like that. And then I can't remember. Is it actually? I should probably put this in as well. I guess it's the default, but just to be sure. So constraint with the what did you call this?
I know I said engine NODB default.
That's just a it's a MySQL specific thing we put in there. It's just to specify that we want the storage engine to be InnoDB.
Okay.
It's the default on most recent versions, but it's a good good thing to be specific about it.
Okay.
And sometimes you want to put something else here. Mostly you're gonna use InnoDB, but there's a bunch of different ones that have some other advantages. Yeah, and default character set and collation is we talked about that before.
Yeah.
Also, so yeah, I think I would call this something like foreign key article author.
You need to put the word key there beside primary, or does it? Is
oh yeah, you're right. That's me. Primary key. That's and actually we forgot the primary key for the text table, so nicely spotted. Primary key ID. Okay. So yeah, it's foreign key and And then can't remember if it's parentheses. Yeah. So author ID references authors ID. And what did you put as the on delete? For this, you put the cascade. No, you can do undelete set null.
Sorry, yeah, set null.
Yeah, but then you have to have a nullable. Nullable column, otherwise you're going to get an error, because right now we specify not null for both these values. So if you try to set it to null, it will say you cannot do that.
On delete cascade is the convenient.
Yeah, it's probably the one you're going to use most, because it means that whatever row is in this table, if I delete an author, then all the rows with that author is going to be removed, and the same for articles. You could of course also say restrict here instead. Then you could not delete it before you deleted all the rows that it references. But for this example, I would say cascade. So we're going to have one more of this. For articles, article author. This, and then we only have one left. It's basically going to be the same thing. So I'll just copy it so we save a little time. So maybe I would move these around actually. Like this. Then say tag ID. Say tag ID. Article tags. Article ID. That's work. Let's try it out. I'll just copy it to make sure. There we go. Nicely done.
So we post that code in the stack?
Yeah. Yeah. I'll just post it. Do you have any questions for this exercise?
Wow.
Anything you are unsure about?
In real world, it's the same code you're using in the company.
Yeah, pretty much.
There's no more like.
There's no magic sauce or anything.
Things, no.
I mean, is this just a lot more,
yeah.
Basically? So like maybe you can easily have hundreds of tables.
But usually, like when you work, like it's rarely to build databases. It's usually also manipulation or
it's
getting data.
It's like because the first steps are of course creating the tables, but that's mostly been done beforehand. So
yeah, it's all
once you get in, it's just
yeah.
Maybe you change a column once
select.
In a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, and select a lot of select.
It's all select. Yeah.
Especially if you are doing like if you are analyzing a lot of data after the fact, then yeah, select and join,
yeah.
all over the place.
What do you do in your job? Just connect when your bosses or colleagues ask you specific data, then you present them with tables, or?
We have an API. And that delivers data to a JavaScript frontend, like an Angular app.
Okay.
So that's how we present the data. And then either a table or, it could be any kind of presentation.
Okay.
So it gets into the template.
What's the word data scientist assistant mean? Like, it's a big word, you feel, but it doesn't.
Yeah.
It's
data
not
scientist
like that.
Assistant.
Like when they say, yeah.
I'm not sure. I guess data scientist is about doing analytical work and
yeah.
trying to find patterns in
ask
data
Google.
And stuff.
Ask
yeah,
Google.
Ask Google. I would say.
Maybe
I guess assistant is.
Yeah. More. Or maybe
why would
maybe.
Yeah.
But yeah, data science is all about getting a huge amount of data or big data, as it's known sometimes. And
you have to be very organized. It doesn't.
Yeah. you can learn it. I mean,
yeah.
It takes time, but yeah, you can definitely learn it.
A person employed to analyze and interpret complex digital data,
okay.
such as uses statistics of a website, especially in order to assist business or some kind of decision making.
Hmm.
So
yeah, so
maybe
you.
They are most like analyst.
Analyst,
yeah.
Analyzing. So the boss comes over and says, okay, we need to know how many orders we had last month that had some issue or that
didn't
go well, or maybe how many products did we sell that something like that. I mean, so you have to translate what they say into some kind of SQL statement.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Homework.
Yes, the last homework for databases. At least I think so.
Really.
Have you read through it?
Yeah, but I did not understand what should we do.
Oh, okay. Well, let's see. Using an entity relationship diagram, design the data model for an application of your choice. This could be anything, but previous students have used a small business, a library, or a farm. Your application must include at least one many-to-many relationship and any supporting tables that are needed. Yeah.
So it means we have to create, for example, a small business database.
Yeah.
With the staff, offices, and job title, these credentials.
Yeah, that could be one way to do it. I mean, yeah, you can choose whatever
and
kind
what
of.
What will you do after?
So yeah, the first part is just doing the entity relationship diagram. So you can use, I think there was actually posted here in Slack a really nice tool. yeah, that's also a good tutorial to watch. Where was it? Was it general? This one.
You can just with the pencil at first.
You can maybe
just understand the relationships between your entities.
Mm. Yeah. So you start by you can also do it on paper and just send a photo or something, whatever you like to do.
And then it's on the what is it called?
I guess workbench. The workbench has some ER diagram stuff in it.
It has diagrams, so you write it on paper, then you do it in Workbench, and the Workbench transfer it automatically to tables, so you don't need to write the tables even.
It writes the create table statements for you.
It's easier.
Mm. You can do that, or you can do it on paper if you want, and.
Yeah,
it's all about how you want to do it. But basically, the only real requirement is that you have to have one many-to-many, and of course, there's probably going to be other relations as well. So try to think of some kind of thing you can model that has a natural many-to-many relationship.
Employee customer.
Could be. Yeah, and then next time we'll go through the homework solutions, and then you'll start learning about React.
Are you the teacher for React?
Nope. I wouldn't know how to do that. I'm only, I know Angular a little bit, but React is like, yeah.
You UX part only Java?
I know about databases and backend development mostly. So, but I do a bit of front end sometimes when I have to.
Yeah.
It's not always you can choose yourself, so that's maybe important to note. And it's also good to be versatile.
Mm.
It doesn't hurt to try something new. Yeah. So is the homework clear for everyone?
I hope so.
Yeah. I mean, the text is a lot longer than it needs to be, I guess. It's mostly just draw an entity relationship diagram or ER diagram in some kind of way, either on the computer or in just by hand. And remember to submit that along with the create table statements. So, yeah. I guess that's pretty much it.